Hi folks, today I bring another panel based on the PT6311. The panel belongs to the Philips and is used in the model LX3700D/22S. The service manual with the schematics is available on the web, and there we can easily find the panel that I bring you here. I will not tire you out with the segments identification method or with the construction of the charge, read keys, infrared. We covered the process in the previous videos related with the PT6311. I only point out that we are using the plus 5 volts DC source to power the filaments and at the same time power a DC-DC converter. This converter is total isolated from the plus 5 volts DC to the 24 volts DC, where we will go use the 0 volts as a less 24 volts DC. Hence, I highlighted the importance of the converter being isolated between the input and the output. We use two IN4004 diodes to cause a drop of 1.4 volts, thus leaving us 3.6 volts for the filaments. We then chose the point of the filament F1 or F2 as a reference of our voltage to see which one point show less shadows in the digits. This shadow is due to the fact that the filaments are being fed with DC power. The correct thing, as I have already mentioned several times, would be an AC voltage instead of the DC to power up the filaments. The VFD has 10 grids, and the grid 0 is divided in two, appearing half at the left and half in the right to represent strings and the predefined symbols. For those who like the VFDs, I suggest you stay tuned for the next video, as it is my intention to use this VFD to demonstrate how it is possible to test the VFD driver without resorting the programming that has so often been requested. This is our connection, and you can see here the input of the power source, independent power source of plus 5 volts DC. You can use, for example, a power bank. And at the same time, the 5 volts DC powered up our converter, simultaneously powered up our filament. You can see here the both diodes, they stay in the serial with the filament, and after you see the block of the output where you get the 0 volts, and this 0 volts will be connected through the resistor. In this case I use 470 ohms to the F1 or F2. You select which show less shadows in the filaments. The plus 24 volts go direct to the GND of our Arduino, and the 5 volts of the Arduino will power up the PT6311. This is a low current, it's no problem. After, you have the pin of data, the pin of clock, and pin chip enable. This is the identification of the segments, and here you can see the below view of the panel, but of course you have the schematic in the web, you can see it in better way. Okay, this is my both wires which go to the filaments, and you can see here the both diodes, and this is my reference, this is my
less 24 volts. In this case, it's connected to the... Okay, we will go call this F2. And if I change... I remove, okay, the VFD stay off. And after when I connect here, you will see here the shadow is more intense in this point. I turn again to the F2 and the shadow is not so present here.